It's just hot in here. Hey, amen. This is not the beach. I got my shirt. Nobody out. All right. Glory to God. Well, first of all, let's how many know the importance of giving of thanks? Acknowledging God before we even do it. I know it's hot up in here, but I think the easiest way to give God His praise is do His name. The Bible says you brought a thanksgiving offering into the house of the Lord. Even though we receive the tithes and offering, praise God, that's not what God really needs from us. He's got cattle on a thousand hills. The streets of this city is paved with gold. So our money is not what He really wants. He really wants our appreciation, our thanks, our gratitude. Praise God. The Bible says be thankful unto Him and bless His name. Because the Lord is good. Hallelujah. So, hallelujah. You better not know how to do that, but let's just stand for a minute. I'm going to show you. Remember what David says in Psalms 34 and 11? We saw that in Sunday school this morning. Anybody remember what it says? Sunday school class? Okay. Come, you children, I'll teach you how to be successful with God. That's what David said when his enemy was chasing after his life and he discontent, the in debt, and those who are unsatisfied with life. 400 of them became David's army. He became the captain of them. And this is what he said, come with me. I'm going to teach you how to be successful with God. Yeah. Hallelujah. That's what David said, Psalms 34, 11. Praise God. He was running for his life at that time. So I'm on. I'm just going to show you, teach you how to get into the presence of God. Some of us, you already know that, praise God. Hallelujah. He's in prayer. I got this one in prayer this morning. Brother Travis was praying. He's saying, here's how you enter in. Hallelujah. How many got that? Hallelujah. And the fourth thing about that is that it was kind of for my voice to hurt it. Hallelujah. Some of y'all got better voices than me. Hallelujah. As soon as you get to that, we're going to be in the presence of God. Let the whole house be in His presence. Hallelujah. My voice should be here, Father. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. It's the best instrument in the house today. My voice. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thanks in life. Hallelujah. Glory to God. What would I tell him for all his goodness toward me? Hallelujah. Glory to God. I will bless him at all times, and his praises shall continue to be. Hallelujah. My soul will make its boast in the Lord, and the humble will hear thereof. They'll be glad. Hallelujah. When they hear my voice. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. We'll go from strength to strength. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Well, Father, we thank you today. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. My boast is in the Lord. Hallelujah. My boast is in the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for keeping me alive. Hallelujah. Thank you for your strength. Amen. Thank you for your word. Give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name. Let the church say amen. Glory. Hallelujah. Oh, bless the Lord. You might be seated. Hallelujah. You know, you go down here and you get in your car tomorrow. Hallelujah. You have the Monday morning blues. You don't really want to go to work. Say that job's not making me the money that I need. Hallelujah. I'm talking real. Can I talk real?
Yeah.
Amen. What shall I do? How shall I petition God? How can I get in front of him? First thing you want to do is go, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, what is that do? Boy, that tears down. I make the devil so mad. And he just, he's running for cover. Give him thanks. Give him thanks. Hallelujah. I heard that some walls fell down because a group of people marched around in a circle and said, Lord is good, and his mercy endured forever. That's all they did was march, and a big wall fell down. You want your walls to fall down and step in your way? Hallelujah. Glory. Give thanks. This is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Hallelujah. It's 10 lepers healed one day. They all got healed and started to walk away. Only one of them turned back around and said, thank you. Glory to God. Only one turned back around and said, thank you. Hallelujah. That touched the Lord so much that the Lord healed, made them whole. Everything is like concerning them. The Lord has turned their mind. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So, let's talk today on the subject that Pastor Hill has been working with, and I know the ones that I Bible studies have been dealing with righteousness. Just wanted to kind of bring a little bit more perspective to that, praise God, and understand how does a man make it to be successful with God. Hallelujah. See, I've been saved for some 30-something years, it seems like yesterday. But when I look back over the audience and see my kids, I can see that it must have been longer than that. Especially because my wife is pregnant with our son. And he's, how old are you, Donnie? 34 years ago. It was more than that because she was pregnant with him. So, 34 plus 9 months. Glory to God. So that's how long. Through my adult life, walking with the Lord, through the ups and the downs, money, no money, stress, distress, comfort, discomfort, hallelujah, all type of situations and trials, you say, how do you do it, how is it possible to live saved and to get victory in this life? Or it actually has to do with the subject that Pastor Hill has been talking about and studying in Bible study, the righteousness. It's called a righteousness. And it's not my merit or what I have done, but it's recognizing who I am in Christ. What the Lord thinks of me and of you. You have to think about how God thinks about you on his terms. See, the Bible says that man's righteousness is what? Filthy rag. Think about what he's done, what he can accomplish, has accomplished, what man can do, it's just not there. Let's go to, I think it's Romans 11 chapter, and you see an earnest prayer of the Apostle Paul. That might be Romans 10 chapter. I think that's Romans 10 chapter. Yeah, Romans 10 chapter. Chapter 1, he says, "Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved. I bear them record that they have a zeal of God, but not according to knowledge. For they've been ignorant of God's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God. For Christ is the end of the law of righteousness to everyone that believe." Now, I bear the record that they want to do right, that they think they know God, but it's not according to knowledge. Knowledge, what knowledge? The knowledge of what has been done on your behalf through Christ Jesus to present you faultless before God's throne. When God looks at us from his throne, he wants to see us. He looks through Jesus and he says, "All I see is my children." He's like a father with his children. All he wants to do is bless and do good for them. That's how our Heavenly Father is with us. He said, "All right," he says, they want to do good with their, on their own strength, but he says, that's not how it works. It works as though it's like being ignorant, verse 3, ignorant of God's righteousness, going about to establish their own, and the key word, submit. They have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God. And so this is what we want to see, just what is that all about? Because when you are righteous, and you know you're righteous, and how do you know that? And just to put it in a nutshell, you know that you are a child of God. You believe in your heart what Jesus has done for you. You believe with all of your being. That's what the heart is. Not the fleshly pumping heart, but your core being. You live and breathe Jesus Christ, the reality of what he has done for me. Hallelujah. And the more you take that in and absorb that, the more you can say that the Lord is on my side, I don't fear anything. I'll show you in the scripture here just a little bit, praise God. I'm going to be 60 years old here in a couple of months. October 1st, hands up. No pills, lotions, or potions. Keep me ready. Glory to God. And up until about 4 or 5 years ago, I found out where everybody in church. That's right, Lord. I would give you a run for your money. Some years ago, that's an old man. I can't do it now. All the time is catching up. Glory to God. But for the last 34 years, I've walked and enjoyed the righteousness of God. Glory to God. And I talk big, and I keep talking big, and it keeps coming to pass. Because I can talk big, because the key word is confidence. If you take nothing away from you today, take this. If this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he does what? He hears. Hallelujah. He hears. And the key word is submit. Submit to the righteousness which is of God. I'm going to show you the importance. I'm going to pray to show you the importance of your voice. That's why I started off by saying your voice has to be heard. It has to be heard. How many have heard the term, I hope I'm not getting off too far, the term ether? E-T-H-E-R. How many? Well, I hope you have heard that? Ether. That is, how many have ever had a transistor radio? How many heard of the radio station? Well, between your transistor radio in your pocket and the radio station, it's got to be something in between there. You can't see it. It's called ether. How many have computers at home? GPS systems in your car, all over the place, in your pockets. There's something between you and what's making that device go. It's called the ether. What is the ether? It's between it. It connects. Gets you there. Gets what you want from there to here, here to there. Ether. Hallelujah. So, let me ask the question, how many have heard a lion roar? Been to a zoo or somewhere, and you heard a lion roar. The first time I heard a lion roar, it scared me to death. Whoa! He's serious. And then when he's not real loud, he's going, wow, I'm just killed. What's the king of the jungle? The lion. When the lion wants to go lay down over there where Sister Dorothy is, he doesn't tell her. Wow. And everybody in the jungle does what? Get out of the way. They hurry through the ether. Here he comes. Don't mess with the lion. He's king of the jungle. I actually put that scripture in a minute. Sister. So, I'm going to show you what David says about how we are supposed to walk around here today. I want to tell you before you get there, you're the king of the jungle. If you're saved, you believe Jesus is Lord and Savior, from the day you got saved to the day you go home with the Lord, you are the king of your jungle. And you got the roar. That's called your voice. Hallelujah. So y'all with me? All right, here we go. Right where we are in Romans, the 10th chapter, verse 6. But the righteousness which is of faith speaks on this wise. The righteousness which is of faith speaks like this. In other words, it's heard. It's spoken. It's audio. Say not in thine heart, who shall do what? Ascend into heaven. That is to bring Christ down from above. Or who shall descend into the deep? That is to bring up Christ again from the dead. But how does it speak? The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thine heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. Many of us are bound, doomed, not victorious, however you might want to describe it, simply because we are not convinced in our heart to speak our desires. Glory to God. I'm just trying to make it as simple as I can say that without you speaking what's in your heart to your situation, it won't change for you. And it goes back to the simplicity of receiving the gospel. I think it's verse 10 or 9. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thy heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believe unto righteousness, and with the mouth, the speaking, the roaring, confession is made unto deliverance. That salvation is deliverance. And whatever you want to be delivered from, you have to roar it. And it goes through the ether. Ether. The ether. Invisible. Call it the atmosphere if you want to. But it moves through. That's why David says, my voice should you hear in the morning. At the beginning of the day, I'm going to call the shots. Here's how the day is going. Glory. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. From the rising of the sun till it goes down the same, the name of the Lord is to be what? Praise. And the devil's trying to knock you off that track. Don't praise, complain. Stop roaring, act like a mouse. Glory to God. No matter how, whatever the situation, whatever's in your jungle that you want to get control and have dominion of, like I said in Psalms 8, you give him dominion over the work of your hands, that man has got to roar. This is the way it's going to be today. today. I will be well today. I shall not die, but live today. And the devil doesn't want you to say anything on that order, because he knows that whatever you believe in your heart and you say it with your mouth and you say it with confidence, it will come to pass. Glory to God. That's just the way God designed it. And many people don't know. They walk around defeated and grumpy and complaining the whole nine yards through life because they have not according to knowledge, have they submitted themselves to God's will. All right. Hallelujah. Let's take it back from the start. Go back to about chapter 3 in the book of Romans. Let's look at some things here before we see something that I hope it'll be a blessing to you in the book of Psalms. But here in Romans 3:10, and Candy, what verse was that you found? Romans 14:23? Okay. We'll get there in a minute. Okay. All right. Romans 3:10. I'm helping here. As it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. There is none righteous, no, not one. This is the indictment that God has placed upon mankind after Adam has sinned and going throughout history before Jesus did his atoning work. There is none righteous, no, not one. Verse 11, there is none that does what? Stand. There is none that seek after God. They're all going out of the way, altogether unprofitable. There is none that do good, no, not one. And just keep reading that and go down to verse 18. There is no fear of God before their eyes. And as I was speaking a while ago, before we leave the book of Romans, in Romans 14 and 23 says that anything that's done that is not in faith is sin. So the enemy of man is sin. Whatsoever that is not of faith is sin. So you got, listen, you hear the word sin, the subject is righteousness. So what's keeping me from being in the fullness of righteousness is going to be sin. And if I'm not walking around in faith, making my declarations from my heart that I believe what the will of God is and saying it with my mouth, and doing anything contrary or below that, it is called sin. Whatsoever is not of what?
Faith.
Is sin. And that's the only thing that can keep me from moving with God. So I have got to learn to walk in faith and declare what my heart says with my mouth. And though it might seem strange, difficulty, weird, boastful, you name it, to somebody else, it's faith talking. And we're either gonna talk faith or we're gonna live sick. Oh, the Timothy's still open. We're gonna talk faith or we're gonna live broke. We're gonna talk what God says or we're gonna live in defeat on this earth. And then go to heaven and find some splendor. I don't wanna be like that. I want to get a taste of what the Lord has for me right now. Glory to God. What is man that you're so mindful? You think so much of me. What am I to you? You gave me so much to me. Hallelujah. Now all I have to do is roar in my jungle. And if I'm a lion, I roar, I talk, I say what's in my heart, what I want to do, because I am king of the jungle. I'm the lion. If you don't believe me a lion, I'm going to show you. Hallelujah. Okay, Psalms 14:3. Ooh, Psalms 14, verse 1 through 3. Here's what it says. The fool has said in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt. They've done abominable works. There is none that do good in it. We kind of heard something like that over in Romans, because it says, as it is written, and what was that written? David had discovered it long back. The fool has said in his heart, there is no God. Verse 2, the Lord looked down from heaven upon the children of men to see if there were any that did understand that seek God. They are all gone aside, they are all together become, the word here is filthy. Actually, it means corrupt. There is none that do good, no, not one. Have all the workers of iniquity no knowledge? Eat up my people as they eat up bread, and call not upon the Lord. I'm going to go to verse 7. Oh, that the salvation of Israel will come out of Zion, when the Lord bringeth back the captivity of his people, Jacob shall rejoice, and Israel shall be glad. In other words, it said here, oh, that deliverance was really obvious. The people will be glad when they know that their deliverance is so obvious and so near to them. Paul said, it's so near to you, it's in your mouth. That is the word of faith that we preach. That's how close it is. Let me go on this a little bit further here. Okay, Psalms 53, verse 1 through 5. The fool has said in his heart, once again, there is no God. Corrupt are they. They're an abominable iniquity. It's not that they do good. God looked down from heaven, children of men, see if there were any that did understand. They did not seek God. Every one of them is going back, all together, become filthy. Verse 4, have the workers of iniquity no knowledge, neither my people as they eat bread, they have not called upon the Lord. Verse 5, there were they in great fear where no fear was. For God had scattered the bones of him that encamped against thee. Thou hast put them to shame because God despised them. Now, verse 5 again. There were they in great fear where there was no reason to be scared. No reason to be scared. That's how the devil wants us now, to be fearful. What are you scared of? You're in the jungle. You're the lion. What are you scared of? And a while ago when I said, how do you get into the presence of God? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Two or three gathered together in his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And there were some folks whose lips didn't even move. What's going on? Fear. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. When was the last time you said that? I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Glory to God. I can do all things through Christ. See, the lion is roaring. He wants to go sit over my daughter. Don't be here through the ether. She gets up and get out the way. Resist the devil, he'll do what? Free from you. Hallelujah. You're going to be broke, poor, in poverty the rest of your life. The devil's telling you, you got to say something. And though he was poor, rich, for my sake, he became poor. That I can enjoy his riches. I've been saying that for 34 years. I've been fantastic for 34 years. I haven't been forsaken yet. In and out of employment. I don't know what DHS paper filled out looked like. Y'all didn't get that. Glory to God. Okay. Now we'll jump over here. We'll see that the wicked is scared. That fear, well, it doesn't have to be. And it says that in a short sentence that I've already already scattered your enemy. Why are you scared? Because he doesn't have a sense of righteousness. Okay? Proverbs 28 and 1. You gotta run with me through the scriptures. Here we go. Proverbs 28 and 1. The wicked flee, the wicked run, the wicked flee when no man pursueth. Nobody's after him. He's just running for his life. He stays as he can be. The wicked flee, but the righteous is what? There it is. It's back in Oklahoma. We got it. The righteous is as bold as a lion. A lion, king of the jungle, he asks permission from nobody. Where does the lion sleep, rest, do whatever, wherever he shows up? And if you're in the spot that he wants to be in his jungle, you got to leave. Now, many saints and believers don't have that attitude. The money is over there. I'm going to do what? Get it. Woo! I thought that might make us happy. I said, yeah. The money's over there. I'm going to get it. Now the hyena says you can't have it. The little bird cub says, no, you can't do it. But the lion says, I'm going to get it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So I want to read that to me again. Proverbs 28 and 1. Read it out loud from your Bible.
The wicked
is a lion. The righteous is as bold as a lion. He don't need any qualifications and all this. All he has to do is establish in his heart, I'm going to be well. I'm going to have peace.
Yes.
Glory to God. I'm going to glorify God.
Yes.
It's in his heart. And all he has to do is say it with his mouth. That's how simple it is. Just like receiving Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You believe it in your heart and you say it with your mouth and you have established it. With your mouth, confession is made into deliverance. Hallelujah. And you start experiencing all the splendor of being a child of God. And then as you walk through your jungle, you say, that's where I'm going. How did you say that? With my mouth, because it's in my heart. That's where I'm going. But the hyenas and the small animals of the jungle that have no strength will kind of make you think that they got you. No, you can't. You can't do this. That's not for you, guys. That's not the way it should go. All right, praise God. So why am I bringing this out like this? Why do I say it like this? Because I believe that we have not understood our position in Christ. Who we are, we got saved to live a miserable life, we got saved to live bad and then go to heaven, and we can stay saved that long, put up with sickness and buy the prostheses, whatever that crap is that they put on you, hold me up, the braces, and the pills, and the lotions, and the potions. That's not God's will for us. I wish I could find a church that could believe that.
Yeah.
Glory to God. Beloved, above all things, I want you to do what? Be in what? Even as your soul prosper. But the enemy, the devil, says, no, smoke a cigarette, a cigar, some marijuana, make you feel better. Glory to God. The little hyena got you doing everything, and he's controlling and dominating you. Instead of us dominating the jungle. Psalms 8 tells you, gave me dominion over the work of his hand. Made you one. Okay. Now, so here's what we're going to find today is that the Gentiles, that's us, is that if we would walk in God's righteousness, we can have whatever we want in life if it's according to God's will.
Yes.
And how do you go from nothing to something? How do you go from sickness to health? How do you do that? How is that possible? How does faith work? It works that if you believe it in your heart, you got to get the knowledge and you come to believe that and just say it with your mouth. Confession is made into salvation. Now, there's only one thing that can keep you from having confidence from speaking like that. That's sin. Ooh. Sin. Let me show you here. 1 John 3:7. As a kid, I used to walk around with holes in my shoes. Anybody can relate to that? Put a piece of cardboard in there to kind of get you through for about another week or so. I wonder if Timothy's open over there. Man. Somebody might have experienced that. Glory to God. Wore a rope for a belt. Poverty. Sick all the time. Been sick a lot. Not since I've been saved. We used to be sick all the time. How can I get from here to there with God? How? I know God loves me. I know He says He wants me well. I know He says He wants me wealthy. I know He says He that's what His word says. How can I get that into the tangible? Y'all with me, church? Okay, 1 John 3:7. What does it say? He that doeth righteousness, is that what it says? He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. You got to do righteousness. Glory, hallelujah. Let's see here, 1 John 3:7. Little children, let no man deceive you. He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. He that committed sin is of the devil. The devil sinned from the beginning. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil. Now, it's all about who we submit to. If I'm going to walk in darkness, if I'm going to walk in the stuff that I know this does not please God, it's not according to the will of God for my life, if I'm going to walk in that, then that's going to, I can't talk like I'm sick. I mean, I'm well. I can't say it. If I'm full of sin and dipping and diving, chasing and Pastor Hill say catching and all this kind of stuff, how can you say, I'm well? The Lord is the strength of my life. He enlarged my steps, sets my feet on the high places of the earth. You don't have confidence. Your confidence is going to be shaken. So that's what messes up your confidence with God is sin. If there's no sin issues that I'm practicing, I have confidence with God. You will have confidence with God, and you can boldly say, the Lord is on my side. Glory to God. The lion lives in the jungle. It's an uncertain place. You may fall off a cliff, just like you and I are going through life. There's things going on. You might fall off the cliff in life, lose that job. Got that kid, troubled teenager. You might have all of these little cliffs in your life, but you can boldly walk through that jungle, your jungle, and say, the Lord is on my side. Roar. 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 My voice should I hear in the morning. Say, that's the one instrument, one weapon that we do not use. I dare you tomorrow on your way to work, discover something. I'm the righteousness of God. Let's say it to someone on the other side of the land and look at you. The Lord is the strength of my life. Glory. Who shall I fear? What shall I fear? Glory to God. Moving right along. If this has been a blessing to you, say amen.
Amen.
Okay, but the righteousness which is of faith speaks like this. Who shall ascend? That's in Romans 10:6. Who shall ascend? Who's going to do this for me? The Bible says, don't say that. help me get this health? Who's going to do this for me? The Bible don't even ask. Because that's showing doubt. Lord, will you heal me? Lord, will you bless me? That's showing doubt already in the question. Well, who's going to go down because the price? Who's going to pay the price for me to obtain? Who's going to do that? Paul says, stop asking that question because it's already been settled. It's the only variable is you. Your health is up to you. Your wealth is up to you. Your happy home life is up to you. Lord, come in here and straighten out this man. God says, oh, what a waste of time. What a waste of work. Lord, show me how to go with a, get some money, get a better job. Lord says, oh, what a waste of time. This is up to you. Jesus is not coming back down here to do anything but take his church out. The next time you see him, we're leaving. And if you want something going on down here on the earth on your behalf, guess who it's up to? Somebody say you. Me. Hallelujah. You want to be well, it's up to you. Hallelujah. Well, I want knowledge. Get knowledge on that thing. Get some faith on that thing. Stop walking around in unbelief and doubt. Because whatever is not of faith is what? Sin. And that keeps me from getting my answer from God. It keeps the confidence from flowing. Hallelujah. You know, I don't want to talk about myself, but I can always, when a financial challenge comes up in my life, I can review, go back. But I can say, Lord, I'm not practicing sin. I'm not doing all those crazy things like that. I have paid my tithe. And if, I brought the money in, this is a little financial challenge. All right. I expect victory here. Glory to God. So, health. Same thing. Lord, they said he's getting ready for the flu and the cold and the Tylenol and the NyQuil season. Go buy up. Go stock up. It's all on sale. Run to flu shots. Go down there and get you one from the Walgreens store. And go do it. Hurry up and get there for them. Haven't had a flu shot. Haven't had the flu. And haven't had a headache in over 25 years. How are you doing that, Williams? Walking in confidence, talking in confidence. And this is what I'm trying to get over to the church, everybody, that you got to start talking big. I've been talking big a lot of years. Some look at me out of the corner of the eye, but you never see Williams begging for bread. You never see Williams sick. What's going on here? Hello, church. I'm calling shots on the vacations. Just about to call the shots on the car. Gotta get me one more. I already talked to the lady about it. And she says you gotta prove the income before you get that kind of car. No, baby. Look for the car. Look for the car. And somebody challenged me and said something about a Bentley. Now I'm talking way out there, because I know some of y'all's faces, Toyota, Chevrolet, Ford. It's okay, more power to you. But someone's talking Bentley. Bentley. Is that on the Mercedes line? I mean, oh, that's on the Rolls Royce line. Will you dare drive a Bentley in North Tulsa? Can anything good? What's the name of that? anything good come out of Nazareth? Anything good come out of what? North Tulsa. Well, all right. Not the Bentley. How about the BMW? That ultimate machine. See, that talk is, you, is he crazy? He was on vacation too long. To my son. I want you to come up talking like I'm talking. I want you to wail like I'm wail. Hallelujah. Y'all still love me?
Yes.
Amen. So I'm just telling you, this is what David says in Psalms 34 and 11. He had the in debt, the distress, and those that didn't like life. And he says, come you children, and listen to me. I'm going to teach you how to be successful with God. And those 400 people all became multi-millionaires with David. Woo! They didn't have nothing to start off with, but when David's warring and triumphs and victories, and he brought out the silver and the gold, they got a part of it as well. Hallelujah. So, it is. How many can open your mouth with? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. I get into his presence. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. The devil don't want you to say amen. That's what it says. Why shall I be quiet? Oh, my soul. Why shall I be quiet? See? The righteousness which is of faith speaks on this, speaks like this. Faith speaks like this. Hallelujah. Don't worry about who's, how do you go up in heaven and get Jesus to do, how do you go down in the deep part and see if Jesus paid all the price. Don't worry about that. That's showing God. Am I worthy of it? Do I qualify? Do I meet the test? No, don't worry about that. You are a child of God. That's the test. You are a child of God. As a father pity his children, so does the father love you. And Jesus said, if a child asks for bread, will you give him what? A rock or a snake or something like that? No, you're going to have earthly people. You're going to do good things. How much more your heavenly father? Glory to God. If you ask and believe for health, how much more would he give you health? How much more would he give you peace of mind and a happy home? How much more is he willing? He's very much willing to, for you to have that. Don't even ask the question, do you qualify? Should I have my income or my neighborhood? No, that has nothing to do with God. Hallelujah. So righteousness, once you understand your position as righteousness, which means I have a good standing, good understanding, good position, I can come to the Father and I can boldly say, like a lion, make your request known unto God. Boldly make your request known unto him. I believe when Adam walked in that garden, he just, God told him, whatever you call it. Whatever you call it, Adam, that's what it'll be. And Adam just walked through the garden and called it and named it. Because he had a sense that I have nothing separating me from my Father God. Glory to God. It was just somebody told him, you are a sinner. Then he went around pulling leaves off the trees trying to hide. And that's what a lot of people are doing today. They're hiding from every need, but they're hiding from God. They won't dare say hallelujah because they've got to put them in his presence. Then they think they're exposed. God, I'm so unworthy. I'm not worthy enough to say hallelujah. I'm not worthy enough to sing one of Zion's songs. That's what the devil will do to you. He gets you in a trap in a box and he says, now sing one of Zion's songs. Let me hear you sing. Let me hear you smoke that scripture now. I done took your job. Now let me hear you say something. Hallelujah. The Bible says, and with the mouth, confession is made unto deliverance. This is the time to start talking. I will say, oh Lord, he's my refuge and my fortress. He's my God. He's my strength. In him will I trust. Glory to God. Not saying that, being quiet brings you defeat. Glory to God. The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I fear? What shall I fear? But my enemies, my foes come upon me, eat up my flesh, they do what? Stumble and they fall. That's what you got to say. There are hosts that camp round about me, even in this will I be confident. Glory. Cancer, arthritis, you know, blood pressure, low, high, whatever this stuff is. It stumbles and it falls. Glory. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that one thing I seek after, that I might be in his presence all the days of my life. How can I ensure my presence? Giving of thanks. Thank you, Lord. Through the day. Hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah. Glory. Not throw a gun in my head because I thank you out of me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. From the rising of the sun to the going down. Yes. Thank you, Lord. This is the course of the day. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. The enemy not going to know. I got a problem for you. I got a credit report for you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I have no fear. Glory to God. This is nothing. Hallelujah. You should just throw it on the table. Thank you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. You got to say that? Why do you go for such a dog on your cat? Kick the cat across the room because the bill came. I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Glory to God. What's your confession? What do you say? And you can roar through your jungle and you can say, that's where the money is. I'm going over there. I'm going after it. That's what a good neighborhood is. I'm going over there. Well, the devil can say, no, you stay in Ghetto Street Avenue. Glory to God. No, you only deserve a half a bedroom. A half a bath. No garage. Oh, hallelujah. Or you take your vacation and clean out your garage. That's what the devil wants. But you got to say, no, I'm going to the high places of the earth. I would say to you, you should say, I'm going to the high places of the earth. He reckoned my feet like hinds feet. I can walk, he should enlarge my borders. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That's why I encourage you to say and think. Because you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus based on your faith that God raised him from the dead. Yes. Yes. If you can believe that, surely you can say, the Lord is the strength of my life. Yes. He's the strength of my life. There ain't no sickness here. That's the first thing for a prayer line. He said, what are you coming up here to confess? Sister Wayne, maybe help a brother out of here. You say you're sick? Are you sick? No, I'm not. See, if Brother Williams prayed for you, I'm not going to pray that you are sick. I'm going to say, do you have faith to believe that you are whole? You're healed. Do you have faith in the Word? And if you want to go, what are we going to pray about? Yeah. Glory to God. He said, agree with me. Touch and agree with me. Yeah. I'm with you. Yeah. Call your shot. I agree with you. Glory to God. Write your check. I agree with you. Write your ticket. I agree with you. Glory to God. You say, I'm going under, I'm going bankrupt, I'm going under. I can't agree with you. Glory to God. We might as well just turn on the TV and watch something. I'm going under, I'm broke, I'm bankrupt, I'm this and that. We just say, wait. Okay. When you decide to roar, let me know. a war within you.
Yes.
Glory to God. The righteous is as bold as a what? He's walking through the jungle. Glory to God. He don't back down from nothing. Righteous. But the wicked, they flee when no one's after them. They're just scared all the time. Running. Food porn, tied it all, commercials come on, NyQuil. They went to the Walgreens. Stack up. Oh boy, I wonder if Timothy is over. Let's stand, let's have prayer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The righteous is bold as a lion. Glory to God. Some of the things he says is far-fetched. That's only because it's to people who hear it don't know his position. We walk with him as he's in the light. Our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. The Bible says over there in Romans, if he didn't withhold anything from, if he gave his life, if he gave his Son, what would he withhold from you now? All you got to do is ask. Hallelujah. Says so we read earlier, the fool said it, has said in his heart, there is no God. I don't have to reckon with God. I don't have to deal with it. That's what the fool has said in his heart. And he gets just what he's saying by what he believes in his heart. But the righteous believe what they have in their heart, it comes to pass. All things are yours. All things are mine. What would he withhold if he didn't withhold his Son from you?
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Don't be deceived. Read your word. Understand your word. Get knowledge from your word and put it in your heart and say it with your mouth. Glory to God. And deliverance will be so obvious. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Nothing will you withhold. Father, we thank you today for your love and your word. Hallelujah. It's right from the very beginning. And we thank you, Father, that the more we learn of you, we learn of our status, our position with you. All things are ours. You freely given. You gave your Son when we weren't worth anything. When we were worthless, unprofitable, corrupt in our minds, you gave your Son Jesus, offered up his life for us.
Thank you, Lord.
So, Father, how would you not, how could you withhold anything from us now? If we ask according to your will, according to your good pleasure, we have confidence. Hallelujah. So we boldly make our requests. We boldly make our confessions. We boldly say, therefore I have believed and now I speak.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. When we roar through the ether, through the world, through the universe, when my voice you hear, I thank you for giving me that dominion and authority on this earth. Hallelujah. So I use my voice. You're here in the mornings. You're here through the day. Hallelujah. The enemy will hear it. My friends, my foes will hear it. But I will speak as thus I believe. And I thank you, Father, for the confidence that I have in you. This is the confidence. If we ask anything according to your will, you hear us and you grant it. We give you all the praise and glory. Not that we are materialistic, but that we're the children of God. We bring glory and honor to your name. Hallelujah. We're difference makers on the earth. There's a distinct difference between us and the sinner, the saved and the lost. We operate differently. We speak, we talk differently. We thank you, Father, for you have called us out of darkness into your marvelous light, that we should show forth your praise that has done all the work. Give you all the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Let the church make a roar. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Let the church make its roar. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I can do all things through Christ. Strengthens me. Hallelujah. want to touch and agree on? Prayer, any such thing as touching. Let's do that. Let's believe. The Bible says any sick, pray to be one for another. To be healed. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Touching and agreeing, projecting out directions, anything. Hallelujah. This is what the church is for. Gathering strength. We'll go from strength to strength, faith to faith. Hallelujah. Everyone appearing before the Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. Now to him is able to keep us from falling, present us faultless before his great throne. To the only true and wise God, our Savior, be glory, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Let the church say, amen.